Good morning, everyone. This is Laureen Giorgio with Living with Victory. We want to wish everyone a very, very happy new year. We realize that some of you are saying the big deal, another year of my problems. One year is like any other. The difference is that we get to choose if we will go into this new year with Jesus. We have a fresh, clean year ahead of us. Some things will be good and some will not. But choosing to walk with Jesus makes all the difference in the world. If you make one resolution for this year, we hope you will choose a closer walk with the Lord. You will be amazed at how you can get through the challenges that will face you this year. You will also begin to see His hand in even small events. And because you put your faith in Him, your faith will help you get through that year and hold you up. And you will be amazed that you will be finding yourself actually expecting to see His hand to resolve your problem. And your joy will return, your hope will rise, and your faith will increase. Remember, He is your umbrella. We hope you will enjoy the rest of the program and the music to follow.
It's time for Living with Victory, a program of hope and encouragement brought to you by Friends of Compassion and listeners like you. Now, here are your hosts, Tony and Laureen Giorgio, with today's message of perseverance.
Jesus is with me when the storm clouds gather, when the winds of this world are blowing strong.
I'm your host, Tony Giorgio. Today's program, we're going to talk about faith. And when you pray, having faith is believing something not yet seen, right? So when you pray, we're going to talk about accepting it as being done. And to help today is my wonderful co-host, Laureen, who's a lot better at this than I am. And I figured between us, we'll get the point across. And I want to say good morning, Laureen. How you doing?
I'm doing fine, and I'm so happy to be here. Good morning, everyone.
Thanks, Laureen. And now we'll get the scripture of the day. And being that you're here, I'll let you read it. How's that? Okay, it's from Philippians 4:6.
Do not fret or have any anxiety about anything, but in every circumstance and in everything by prayer and petition it. Definite request with thanksgiving.
With thanksgiving, continue to make your wants known to God. That is really, really something. And I believe you've got something there out of David Wilkerson's newsletter that pertains to this, right? You want to read that right now, Laureen?
When we are hurting, we are by all means to cry out to our Lord. When we are in anguish over our situation, we are to pray, Lord, help. We are to bring Him all of our hurt and disappointment, for He desires to hear us. Then, after we pour out our heart to Him, He desires us to rise up in faith, face our trial, and proclaim, I can do nothing on my own. God is my strength. Therefore, I will not fear. I'm going to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Israel sang a song of victory after their deliverance, yet they sang it not in faith, but in relief. It was a song without a foundation of trust. That was revealed 3 days later when Israel reverted to their old ways of doubt and fear at their next predicament. Beloved, we have a tender, loving Father who is touched by the feelings of our infirmities. Even Jesus wept in His trying hour, and He has sent His Holy Spirit to comfort us, speaking hope and peace to our souls.
You know, that's what sort of happens. What takes place is you pray, you have the faith, you get your answer, and now you rejoice. What David Wilkerson was saying in his previous newsletters and what we're trying to say today is rejoice before the answer is there. Rejoice as if the answer is there. and live it as if you have it.
Definitely. God wants us to trust Him, but He wants us to trust Him that the answer will come before it comes.
That's very true. And we've been there many, many times. In fact, starting the organization, the ministry up 30 years ago to help these kids, if you remember, I was doing pretty well in the job. I was headed up the ladder of success, so to speak. And along came this calling that I couldn't let go, right? And it wasn't you, it was more me.
Oh, definitely. I have to admit, for a while there, I didn't understand at all what was happening.
I had this driving energy that I needed to help these kids who were not getting help. You know, we're trying to pay our bills just like everybody else. We're praying about it. But we kept going. You know, we kept doing as if we had it. And we didn't. We didn't have the finances. We had nothing. We were still working. We were doing. And here it started to blossom little by little. But we kept going as if we had all our bills paid. We had $100,000 in the bank, and none of that. All we did was we kept praying.
You cannot do anything without saturating your problem in prayer. God has to hear from us. You know, we want to trust Him, but He wants to trust us too. And He just wants to know that His children love Him that much to trust Him.
Isn't that the truth? And that's where it all comes out. The rock-solid faith comes in when you say, thank you, Jesus, because I know you've already have the answer. It may not be today. It may not be tomorrow. It is not my time. It's your time. This would alleviate so much stress today, especially with all the woes of the world that are around us and the economic downturns and everybody looking for second and third jobs. And I know, it's pretty pathetic. In fact, I remember, and I think you too, the eating of the peanuts for dinner. I know. You remember that, Laurie?
We didn't go hungry.
But that's the point. You move and you do. The Lord is there to open the sea for you. And He will. He will. But He wants to know that you're also thinking He will open the doors for you. That's really what the prayer is all about.
Yes, it is. And there's also the other side to this, is that sea didn't open until Moses put his foot in the water. He had to obey God, and we need to obey God. There's an old hymn that's trust and obey. There's no other way to please God. If He's telling you to put the foot in the water, put the foot in the water, even if you don't understand it, because He will then make things work out.
It's true. And there's so many occasions in our lives that we can tell you, you know, we left the family in New York. We were born and raised in New York, but we took off for Florida. We didn't know what we were doing, where we were going. I mean, things were just upside down, but something said go, we did. You need to step out, and I think that's a problem today that I see around me where people have been caught up in fear. You know, the news tells you this, and that everybody's running around crazy. It's, you know, it's the end of the world, you know, blah, blah, Jesus is coming. Yeah, that's fine. Don't worry about it. He said don't worry about it. You know, do until it's time. We're not looking at that. We're too fearful. I can't explain the thing that the fear is making us do. It's not making us have faith.
It's paralyzing us. And once we become so fearful that where we don't move, you can't think. And you can't trust. You have to keep God in front of you at all times.
You know, that's about the right thing if you say you believe in God. And I don't mean that, you know, you go to this church, you go to that church, you go to this church. Yeah, that's cool. That's religion. But if you believe in Christ, you believe in God, you believe in the Holy Spirit, you believe in what they can do for you, that's where it's all at. It doesn't have to be in a building. You are the building, and you have to remember that, especially now. Otherwise, what have you done about the situation? Yes, you prayed, but you have to step foot in the water. So remember that you've got some power behind you, and just think of your prayers being answered. Now, what you want may not be for you, because you understand he sees it ahead of time. He's been there, done that. I do want Laureen to read another piece for us, because it's really important to sink this in. And again, this is from Dave Wilkerson. This is some of his newsletters that we've had. A dear, dear friend of ours and the family of his, we knew real well. And we stick to people that we know have a lot of truth in them. Go ahead, Laurie. You read this, because I think it's going to bring it all home.
Songs of victory sung after victory are not true songs of faith. Why? Our doubts are not dealt a death blow by our experience. You see, when we experience victorious deliverance, we have a temporary flush of thanksgiving. We're naturally joyful because our God has mercifully acted on our behalf despite our doubts. Yet what happens to our doubts then? They are only submerged deeper in the heart. Dear Saint, the fact is God has led you to your current situation. You are surrounded by obstacles on all sides, with what seems like an enemy closing in. And like Moses, you may be saying, Lord, you've led me faithfully all my life, but I don't understand what I'm going through. The future looks so bleak. Right now, we are living in a time of chaos the world has never seen, and Satan is using fear to torment multitudes. In the very midst of this time, our Lord is calling his people, saying, how will you deal with this? Are you going to believe my promises in spite of everything else that takes place around you? Will you trust me in spite of your deepest fears? To do this, we have to fix our minds on the Lord. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee. That's Isaiah 26:3. Our will has to be involved in this. No matter how unbelievably dark our situation becomes, something of faith has to rise up in us that says, no devil, no world, I will trust in the one who has faithfully delivered me at all times. That is when perfect peace comes. It is supplied by the Lord himself, who is pleased by our trust in him. Then, as chaos reigns all around us, our lives will speak the powerful message of his joy. He has given us a song to sing to the world. The Lord is faithful. He sees his people through.
Isn't that the truth? So what are we pretty much tried to say today? We're coming to a close. So what are we telling them, Laurie?
We're saying, on this side of your problem, praise God and trust him, because he is a faithful God that can be trusted. And if you think back through your life, think of all the things he has answered for you and supplied for you.
Isn't that the truth? And we've got tons and tons of things that have been answered. This is Tony Giorgio, and we love you. You have a great week.
I must tell Jesus all of my troubles. He is a kind, compassionate friend. If I but ask him, he will deliver, make up my troubles quickly and end. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear these burdens alone. Tempted and tried, I need a great Savior, one who can help my burdens to bear.
I must tell Jesus, he all my cares and sorrows will share. I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear these burdens alone. Got to tell him all of my trials, tell him all of my burdens, every one of my cares. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, Jesus can help. Jesus alone. God bless you.
Bravo, Ines.
The Lamb once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in and lit a little light from heaven, filled my soul.
Is my friend, and he watches day and night. Well, I go to him in prayer. He knows my every care, and just that little talk with my Jesus.
And I
the Lord in the light of His Word. What a glory He sheds on our way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a shadow can rise, not a cloud in the skies, but His smile quickly drives it away. Not a doubt nor a fear, not a sigh nor a tear can abide while we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Sit at His feet, or we'll walk by His side in the way. What He says we will do, where He sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other Jesus but to trust and obey. Oh, trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. And 'tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word, just to rest upon His promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I proved Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him. Trust You more.
Give the world a smiling face,
a smile today.
Helping someone on life's way,
on life's way.
From the path of space,
thank you.
been listening to Living with Victory with your hosts, Tony and Laureen Giorgio, who for more than 30 years have advocated for seriously ill children through Compassion Children's Foundation, today known as Living with Victory Ministries. Support for this radio ministry and our outreach programs comes from listeners like you. Due to current gas prices, many families who have children that receive daily treatments for their illnesses are extremely challenged to even begin to get their child the life-saving treatments they need. Our Fuel for Life outreach supplies gas cards to these families. We've given away more than 700 of Laureen's free CD, Test of Faith, to breast cancer patients, giving hope and encouragement through her experience with breast cancer. You can support all of our programs by sending your tax-deductible donations to Living with Victory Ministries, P.O. Box 1982, Maggie Valley, North Carolina, 28751. Podcasts of this and other Living with Victory programs are also available at livingwithvictory.org. Join us again next time for another uplifting story of Dancing in the Rain. Thanks for listening.